couple, man. Call us back real fast. We got that shit worked out. If you want to comment on Shorty Low and all the ratchetness that is all my baby's mama.
Or if you are one of his baby mamas.
Yeah, please feel free to call in, too. We'll give y'all a couple minutes, man, before we jump to...
Don't call in with no ratchetness.
Into the bumping. But nah, man, seriously, I just think that it's a bad look, man. I think that's a problem with your black folks. I don't think we've cared enough about how we've been portrayed on TV. You know what I'm saying? I realize not everything's gonna be the Huxtables, and honestly, I thought the Cosby Show was corny. But
do you think it put black people in a good light or a bad light?
Cosby Show?
Mm-hmm.
In a great light. I didn't know the Cosbys really.
Yeah.
Well, I'll take that back. I there's a couple Cosby families that exist, but I don't think that represented the masses. But at the same time, what do you want to portray? Do you want to portray 100% reality, or do you want to portray what you know?
So what you're saying is, what I hear is, you don't want Shorty Low to expand the depths of niggerdom by presenting all of this ratchetness and then making all these other bummy ratchet shit look not so bad by comparison. You want
because, man,
to
yo,
say
it,
fuck
it's
the
too much
extremist.
Of a copycat society. You see it. We see it on TV. We see it in videos.
You hear what I'm saying?
And like, cats want to copy it. Hold up. Caller, what's popping?
What up? This is Ill-One.
Ill-One, what up, fam?
Thank you, man.
What's going on?
No,
man,
not too much.
I'm glad they canceled that bullshit.
Why?
Thank you.
Why?
Yeah, because when I saw the... actually, I saw it on Facebook. Somebody posted it on Facebook, the trailer or whatever. I was like, this sets us back at least 400 years.
Thank you,
400 years, nigga. Seriously. It's just terrible. It's like, wait a minute. It puts black men and women in a negative light. It makes it like all black men have nothing but baby mamas. Don't have wives, they have baby mamas.
My question
and
is,
they make a bunch of kids.
Here go my question, Ill.
It's just ignorant all the way around.
Ill, my question is, what if this nigga had a totally different way of operating with his baby moms? And you were like, damn, he really takes care of them. He's really nice to them.
Because,
right. And then all these people who do have multiple baby moms, you know, I'm not talking about the people that don't have them, and I'm not talking about the ones that you think it's like glorifying it for them. The ones who are in those situations, they'd be like, damn, I'm going to do that for my... I'm going to stop beating up my baby
moms. Here's the deal, Phro. Like, there's people that were like protesting against that have seen more of the season than we have. Now, allegedly, there was people, like the baby's moms are fighting, scrapping, overshorting, fighting for attention, just garbage. You know what I'm saying? It's trash. You know what I'm saying?
The baby mamas were the problem. It wasn't Shorty Low. It was the baby mamas, because the baby mamas were ignorant as fuck.
Yeah.
One was called the fighting baby mama. The other one was called a bougie wannabe bougie baby mama.
The dick-sucking baby mama.
With shit like that, it's like, come on now, let's get real.
So they all had nicknames like Flavor Flav's hoes, you know what I'm saying?
No.
That's the problem with it.
I didn't ever see it. So they
but if you read up on the thing, this is what was outlined, and it's bad. That's a bad look. Period. To me, there ain't no getting around it, dude.
Everybody,
what
has,
you laughing about? Because
everybody has fucked up, man. Look,
CAC ass nigga.
Yeah, we got. What does that even mean?
Crack ass, crack ass,
crack. Oh, okay, all right, man. We got this redneck shit in the South, though. Like, we have our own ghetto bullshit, man. We got our ignorant motherfuckers.
So when you see Honey Boo Boo, do you cringe?
I don't even know what the Honey Boo Boo is. What the fuck is Honey Boo Boo?
I don't like Honey Boo Boo either.
Nah, not cringe for y'all. I'm like,
well, there you go.
That's gross.
Well, she's a fucking idiot, but she don't.
Shit.
But do you judge all white people based on Honey Boo Boo?
I judge all white people based on those little kid beauty pageant shows.
Yeah, that's what my people do.
But I'm not an impressionable fucker. I'm not gonna watch Shorty Low show and then want to go out and beat Shorty Low. But believe it or not, there are people that see this shit and they want to go out. They want to do what he's doing.
So a lot of people are going to do the same shit that fucking idiot Johnny Knoxville's doing on Jackass.
And they do.
It doesn't matter.
Do.
Okay, so what? Those are the fucking
idiots.
I'm
turning my argument around with that comment right there.
Whether you like it or not, the perception of black people is looked differently than the perception of white people.
Thank you.
So, you can have Honey Boo Boo and Buck Wild and all that stuff. You're going to have white people like, well, that's not me. That's not me, so whatever about that. But then when they see shit like, basketball wise and shit like that, they're gonna look at like, do they all act like that, or you know, it's
who the fuck saying do they all act like that? The people who have never seen a black person in their fucking life?
No, Mac. You're with a minority, dog. There's not as many of us as there is of you.
That's what we should fix. That's what we should fix.
And when the negative shows on TV, when the negative depictions outnumber the positive ones by like 7-1,
that's a good point.
It's a problem.
That's a good point.
Yes.
So that's
that is a good point.
And that's what we're trying to fight against minorities need more positive people, you know, more positive images on TV with point blank period.
And I'm not trying to drag this conversation away from All My Baby Mamas and Shorty Low and all that, but what did O-Dog do for this perception?
He said O-Dog.
You know, no, he's
Menace to Society. What did he do for it? Everybody was like, oh, he was the coldest. He was the coldest. And then now it's like, oh, well now we're above that and everybody wants to be like them. But niggas was trying to be like him.
There's a difference between film and reality TV, though.
I'll grant you that.
Exactly. The shit that they're putting out as reality TV is actually more detrimental than Menace to Society.
It's not my reality.
Boys in the Hood or whatever. Because it's supposed to be real. So they're going to take it as real, knowing damn well that is not real.
I mean, I guess what it comes down to is organizations and people spoke. And the Oxygen Network buckled. If they really believed that what they were going to do was going to be profitable and a good idea, then they would have stuck with it, and they didn't. So, I mean, it went through the democratic process. Fuck it.
Yeah,
it is what it is.
I want to appreciate the call, my dude, as always, fam.
Right, take it easy, man.
All right, bro.
Man, fuck Shorty Low and all his baby mamas. All right, I said it.
Now, if the government came in and said we need to take this show off the air, it makes black people look bad, then I'd have a problem.
Yeah.
But if the people said it, then fuck it.
It
is what it is.
That's true.
I can't
argue that. That's a good point, man. I'm going to give a couple seconds in case there was another caller. Y'all can get in now or you can get in after Blender to Bump It, man. Y'all take your pick, but...
Here, let's just sit here and watch the phone.
We're going to continue our postscript, man.
I think that what Jmack means when he says watch the phone is fuck off.
have we swayed you, though?
What's that?
Have we swayed you on this argument? I'm coming from.
I mean, kind of. I mean, it's just, to me, it's like if people really had a problem with it. I just don't...
Yo, he's all about capitalism. He doesn't really care.
He is, man.
I like due process.
He doesn't really care about white people. He doesn't really care. He just says, if it was profitable.
Well, see, then, this is still anti-capitalist. I mean, it was lobbied by outside parties. Yeah,
you should not like that part.
You should not like that.
The thing is, if I wanted to form a group and throw a fit about it, then I can do that.
If
I have the right to do that.
If they recorded half of a season and they were like, fuck it. And then they said, no, we started this thing up and then we didn't do it. Then it would be, you know, in the capitalist, interest. But because they recorded a whole season and they were like, hey, we're about to do this, you know, release this show and this is what it is about. Here goes a little sneak peek and everything. And they were like, nope, we don't want y'all to do that. And they were like, okay, we're gonna shut it down.
Right.
That is some crazy shit.
Now here's a twist for you, and I just wanna, I'm still not changing my position, but I do wanna throw this out as a change up.
Appreciate you being balanced with it though.
Let's say this was Rick Ross instead of Shorty Low. A rapper who's still relevant, a rapper that is popular, a rapper that still moves units.
And he gets a pension from the correction facility.
Would it have gotten a different response? You think they would have pushed it through?
They would have been like, fuck you, we got too much money.
Fuck you, women's libs, people. Yeah, we don't care. We run with it.
I think that if it was... I think if it was a Rick Ross or somebody like that that got a machine behind them and everything...
It would have got
they
done.
Would have, good point. They would have,
very
they
good
would
point.
Have changed... It wouldn't have been Rick Ross and All My Baby Mamas. It would have been a different message. The PR.
Boss life.
Yeah, it would have been something totally different.
But,
and then all these chicks keep coming around. And like, damn, you got a lot of kids coming through with a lot of baby
mamas. You know what's crazy, though? If they would have, looking at it from a different perspective, if they would have looked at the angle that they were taking for the show, like, if they took the angle of, look how fucked up this is. Like, God damn, that fucking blows that he's in that situation and went that angle.
Yeah, but if you did that, though, you wouldn't have a star.
And nobody watched it.
Yeah, no one's going to sit to Y'all gonna castrate me on TV and make me look like an asshole? He wouldn't have did it.
That's true.
But it's you. If you glorify it, then yeah, they of course they're gonna be on board because they getting a paycheck.
Right.
So yeah, it is what it is, man. Let's, you know, it's crazy.
You can't fuck
phone
up.
Lines will
you
remain
can't fuck
open.
Up all
man.
The money to make a couple of hundred.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Man, oh man.
Like Mike Tyson would have paid for that interview. Was it Barbara Walters?
Yeah. Oh
yeah. God. If Mike Tyson.
The more he was doped up. Yeah. And, yeah.
If Mike paid for that interview to be crucified by that bitch, then.
Has anybody
you know,
got a quote from that interview at all?
He no, turns
all
into
I know is he was head
an
bobbing.
Animal sometimes.
Yeah.
He's he's a massive depressant, and he's a crazy. Sometimes he puts his fist in my ass. Is that in there? Is
Barbara, in there? I would mess with your pussy.
I think she did say sometimes he basically he takes the pussy.
Yeah, he take it.
Yeah.
I mean, and
Mike was just like.
Yeah. No. He was like.
Right there, that nah, pussy.
Yo, he was head nodding, dog. He looked so peaceful.
Yes,
yes,
Baba. I take
it was
the pussy.
Terrible.
I take the pussy. It's my pussy,
steal
though.
It. I start humping your leg. I don't even care. You're 50, but I still fucking hit it. I would.
That's it. You, I don't know. Let me fuck with Mike, man.
I will
man.
Fuck you until you love me, bitch.
Yo, who was that again?
That was Lennox Lewis. No, was that chick? Was after the press conference.
Yeah, it was a woman, though.
Robert Givens.
No, nah, who he was talking to like, a dude.
Oh, this was in the press interview. Press.
He's like, you faggot. He's like, I'll fuck you till you love me.
That's a couple other. Terrible, there was one when he's talking to a chick though. God, I can't really remember.
Oh, I know the one you're talking about. Yeah, he was like, shit, I make you uncomfortable. Something.
Yes.
He talked to her crazy.
Who was the other dude that tried doing it? Rampage tried doing that show. Where he's humping the chick's leg.
Well, she liked it. That's the difference. That's the core difference. She was like smiling, like, "Why is this black dude humping right. on my
and
leg?"
And he's staring at right. me
but
all seductive, like.
Rampage didn't try to take the pussy though. He was just trying to get a little hump on
just
her
a
leg.
Dry hump, yeah.
That's all. Yeah, I'm all hump. I'm all good.
All right, man. This shit will be, you know, continue.
That's kind
phone
of
lines will open.
Something.
Yeah, we can get there, man. Let's.
Hey, one last thing.
What up?
Mulder brung up. Somebody who could have the what's that? God damn,
man, do that shit a little louder.
I want to tell people what you eating, but it's possible this nigga's eating nuts,
corn nuts.
Somebody who could have an All My Baby's Mama show one day that gets pushed through, and Shirley Lowe is a guinea pig that will break down the walls for this person in the future.
Who got the children?
Lil Wayne.
How many he got?
Yeah, he's got like 6-7 kids.
Yo, he got Nivea though.
He got all these baby mamas and everything like that. One day he could have all my baby mamas.
He probably paid Shirley Lowe to test the water. Hey, nigga.
Hit that record.
You going to find out if it is.
Go kill yourself.
That was fucked up.
All publicity is good publicity. Go shoot yourself in the fucking face.
Can drop a mixtape next week, nigga. There it is, man.
I'm going to unleash mixtape Wayne on you.